How you folks doing? James Klim here. It's a good morning. We actually got snow. Snow is pretty late this year. Just last week at Thanksgiving, this is how it looked. And today, I'm out playing with the dogs and the dogs love it. I do want to address a topic, and I got a question about this when I was teaching down in LA at our class there. And I get more questions about this the last few months, and that's about printing and doing printing for final restorations. I have an open mindset about it. I really think the inlay option is a reasonable option because I think it's much better than a composite. That's what we see in the literature. The one issue I have with anterior aesthetics, though I love printing for my mock-ups, my shells, my transitional teeth, I'm not using printed restorations. That's the polymer type of printed restoration currently for my anterior restorations, and it comes down to this one issue, and that's luster retention of a polymer. That's always been its weak link through the years. Now, we've done composites for years, and we know they do hold up. However, they age quicker. So when I look at materials, particularly in the mouth, it's probably really not a strength issue that we see with these hybrid polymers or a hybrid ceramic. It would be more of a luster retention and how it ages, particularly at the seams. Having done composites for years, particularly when I went through the AACD accreditation process, we had to do anterior composite veneers, which was a lot of fun. I learned a lot about composites during that period of time. But over the years since then, what I've compared it to versus my ceramics is that the composite or a ceramic polymer, they age a lot quicker. And what that means is I can see more stain at the margins and also the luster retention. So that's my big issue that I have with the current thrust that I see with anterior aesthetics is the printing applications are fascinating. And it's not that I have a closed book on it. The biggest question I have is luster retention. And I know, having done aesthetics for years, that the challenge of aesthetics is usually in the head of the patient and the connection and the relationship. And it's a very personal thing. And when you touch that, particularly with a product that maybe has a 4 to 5 year shelf life, then I have an issue with that. Having watched the veneers that I've done for years, there's a lot of veneers that I placed 30 years ago that are still looking really good. And I just had a patient in the other day where I did her veneers, I think in 1999, and I almost forgot I did them until I was watching her mouth as I was numbing for a Emex onlay. And it dawned on me, yeah, I did these veneers years ago and they looked so natural yet out of impress. And my question is, would I see that with the printed hybrid ceramics right now? And I don't see enough evidence to document that. And I don't think it will. So having said that, there's a time and place for the printing. They're accurate. I'm having a lot of fun with it, particularly in my transitional workups. I can make shells, whether it be shells to open the bite or shells for aesthetics. And it's amazing. And I think it's just a good direction to go. But I see a big rush right now where is the printed anterior restoration an alternative to a ceramic? And at least with the evidence I've seen thus far, I'm not convinced it is. So it's probably not a choice I'm going to make with my type of practice where patients come in for more than just aesthetics. They also want longevity. That's the other question I always get with aesthetics is longevity. And even if I were to drop the price, let's say halfway, it's still a lot of money for 5 years. And I think from a business standpoint, we have to look at this. And also, how will it impact the patient down the line? A lot of patients don't remember the consent forms, right? And if something doesn't work to their expectations, it really comes down to expectations. Could there be a problem down the line with the relationship? And I think when you communicate well, it always is better than not. But I have done full mouth cases, beautiful cases with proper consent documentation, communication. There are occasional upgrades where they'll chip or a restoration will come off, mainly because we didn't have a lot to hang on to, and they still think it's under warranty. It's just a mindset, even though we did the consent form, the expectations were set, and they're now in their latter portion of life, and they may not have as much money flow now. And so I have seen this through the years that the more money someone spends in their mouth, the more guarantees they think it should have. And that's not necessarily the case. They have to understand what their risk factors are. And I go through that with every veneer case I do, or full mouth case I do, or even a single restoration. And that is, what's the condition of their mouth that would prematurely age whatever care we're providing for them? And when they understand that, I always tell patients this: I can outperform nature, but what I can do is help you with your quality of life. There's a high probability, particularly if they're younger, that in their lifetime, they're going to need to do some upgrades. Will these last forever? Now, I have some PFM full mouth cases that lasted for 40 years. I did them right out of school, and sure, they didn't look good, but they lasted long enough for that patient to experience that through life without a lot of problems. I've seen the same with ceramics. Impress came out in the early 90s, so I'm still monitoring a lot of those restorations. If they don't have a major biomechanical problem or biochemical problem, I have found that Impress holds up extremely well. And I'm seeing some of these restorations that look really good, even 30 years out. But most importantly is I see good luster retention, and I see integrity at the margins. That's the one area that I see in a polymer type of ceramic or a composite. That's the weaker link, even when it's done at a very high level. So that's my current opinion on it. I have an open mind and I'll keep looking at it. But with my history, ceramic is still the best. And then the other question would be, how about zirconia veneers? I know there's a big thrust in that, particularly from Europe, and we see that in the US. I don't have an issue with that. They can be done extremely well from a standard of care standpoint. And that would be the fit, the integrity, the conservative nature that we can apply them with. The question I would have is the appearance. They don't have that vital look that I like, particularly with the process called metamerism. And that is, they have a tendency to look different in different lights more than a ceramic. The question is, can you use a glaze that would add the fluorescence that you want? That's really the big issue to me. There's a lot to be learned here, and I'm sure as we progress with zirconia, as I've viewed it, and I do a lot of zirconia in my practice, as I've viewed zirconia through the years, what I'm placing now is so much better than what I used to. And quite often now, I will place zirconia posteriorly if I'm rebuilding a mouth, if I'm taking off old crowns. I see zirconia as an advantage there. And I'll blend them in with anterior Emax or Impress. And we can do that. We have some very aesthetic zirconias today, like the Prime. You have the Prime aesthetic as well. If you have a Puck Miller, that is the ultimate aesthetic zirconia that I can blend in with the Emax or Impress. And if it's in the posterior corridors, the posterior smile zone, you can't tell. So we do see a lot of progress there. But as you cross into these new options, I think we have to do some critical thinking. And I like innovation. I think innovation is wonderful. And I think there are some optimistic promises here. I know eventually we probably won't be machining much anymore. We'll be printing everything. Ceramic, alloys, clear through. I mean, in fact, those processes are available now. The question is, will it become a reasonable lab and in-office procedure with the cost and turnaround time? And there's a lot of factors that we have to look at, but I do think that's the direction we're going to go. So I haven't jumped into that anterior printed ceramic polymer approach yet, mainly because I have those questions about luster retention and what I've seen through the years. But I could change, but at least that's my position right now. If you have any comments or questions, make sure you post them below. I enjoyed our time together today. You folks take care of yourself, and I'm going to go back out and play with the dogs in the snow. They love the snow. You take care. Bye now.
Come on, let's go.